One problem is there. The figure shows a system of two concentric sphere, radius R1 and R2, are kept at temperature. This inner T1, outer T2. The radial rate of flow of heat in substance between. Any substance is there in between this. So what will be the radial flow? They have to, we have to find this is proportional to. Four options they have given. Log base R2 upon R1, R2 minus R1 upon R1, R2, R2 minus R1, R1, R2 upon R2 minus R1. To see, when we have to find radial flow, okay. So what we know, rate of flow of heat directly proportional to area, or we know formula dQ upon dT is equal to KA dT upon difference in temperature upon, you can say temperature gradient. To see, suppose I have taken a at x distance, one element I have taken, radius x, of radius x, one element I have taken, of width dx. One concentric spherical of width dx I have taken. This width is dx. Temperature inner is T, outer temperature is suppose T plus dT. So what will be the rate of flow at distance x? Suppose K is thermal coefficient of the substance between the two spheres R1 and R2. So what do we know? Rate of flow of charge. Rate of flow of charge dQ upon dT is equal to what? K area difference of temperature d theta upon dx. This is the formula. So here K, what is area? Area of a sphere of radius x. So area will be 4 pi x square d theta, difference of temperature, that is T plus dT minus T divided by width dx. So here dQ upon dT, rate of flow of heat is equal to what? K 4 pi x square here dT upon dx. If dx and x square we have taken left hand side, so dx upon x square 4 pi k dT. So see, this x varies from where to where? R1 to R2. Inner surface radius R1, outer is R2, temperature varying T1 to T2. So integrate this. From where to where you have to integrate? X integration is from where to where? R1 to R2. This is X, and temperature varying T1 to T2. So integrate this. So dQ upon dT, dx upon x square, 1 upon x square integration, that is x power minus 2, the integration minus 1 upon x, r1 to r2, here 4 pi k, integration of 1 is t, t1 to t2, dq upon dt, so dq upon dt, if you are putting here r2 and this minus minus plus r1, 4 pi k t2 minus t1. So dq upon dt, if we will take LCM here, what happen? Dq upon dt. So that r1 r2, r1 r2, here minus r1 plus r2, 4 pi k t2 minus t1. Minus sign, if you divide in, so what happened? dq upon dt is equal to what? This you have taken this side, the 4 pi k. Here I have taken t1 minus t2. So it becomes r2 minus r1. R2 minus r1, r2 upon r2 minus r1. Here you can see dq upon dt is equal to this. So which proportional? They have asked proportional to what? तो प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर टू आर वन माइनस डिवाइडेड बाई आर टू माइनस आर वन, तो ऑप्शन इज डी. तो हियर वी कैन सी डी क्यू अपान डी टी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर टू आर वन अपान आर टू माइनस आर वन. तो इन दिस क्वेश्चन द रेट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ हीट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर टू आर वन डिवाइडेड बाई आर टू माइनस आर वन. ऑप्शन डी इज करेक्ट. ए रे पी क्यू इंसिडेंट ऑन रिफ्रैक्टिंग फेसेस बी ए रिफ्रैक्टेड बी ए सी सोन एंड इमर्जेज आउट अदर रिफ्रैक्टिंग सरफेस ए सी आर एस. बट दे आर गिवन ए क्यू इज इक्वल टू ए आर. This AQ is equal to the AR and refracting index of prism material is root 3. The angle of deviation. See here. This is incident ray. This is emergent ray. This will be the angle of deviation. If you draw normal at these points, this angle is R1, this is R2. Okay, what we know, R1 plus R2, R2 is equal to angle A. First thing, let's see, if AQ is equal to AR, so this angle are same. And total 90, this is normal, total 90, so 90 minus this, 90 minus this. So this represents the R1 is equal to R2. If AQ is equal to AR, AQR is equal to ARQ. 90 minus AQR is equal to R1. 90 minus ARQ is equal to R2. So R1 is equal to R2. That is equal to how much? A by 2, 60 upon 2. So that is how much? 30 degree. So R1 has 30 degree. What about I1? Sin I1 upon sin R1 is equal to refractive index. Refractive index they have given root 3. So sin I1 is equal to root 3 sin R1. R1 is sin 30. Here root 3 sin 30 is 1 by 2. So here we can see I1 is equal to root 3 by 2. That is how much? 60 degree. So I1 60, R1 is equal to R2 30. And when R1 is equal to R2, that means this is the condition QR parallel to BC. Minimum deviation condition. At minimum deviation condition what happened? Angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. That is also how much? 60 degree. So we know del, whatever is the relation between R1, R2, I1 plus del. If you want to find the del, take a del is equal to I1 plus emergent I plus E minus R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2, that is A. I plus E minus A. I1 and E, that are 60 plus 60 minus 60. So angle of deviation is 60 degree. So here we can see A option is correct. See, in a diffraction pattern, due to a single slit of width A, the first minimum is observed at an angle 30 degree with the light of wavelength 5000 angstrom is incident on the slit. The first secondary maxima is observed. First secondary maxima kahan par observed hogi? They have given sine inverse 1 by 4, sine inverse 2 by 3, sine inverse 1 by 2, sine inverse 3 by 4. See here, angular deviation, take an angle made, that is theta or nearly sine theta is equal to n lambda upon a. When you talk about the first, they have given first minima. For minima, for nth minima sin theta n lambda upon a, first minima n is equal to 1. To put here, to sin theta, theta nearly equal to sin theta, theta they have given 30 degree. To n is 1, lambda upon a, this implies lambda upon a sin 30 is equal to 1 by 2. They want first secondary maxima. See here, first secondary maxima will form 3 by 2 lambda upon a. So first secondary maxima. What happen? First secondary maxima theta sine theta equal to how much? 3 by 2 lambda. 3 lambda by 2 a. So here you can see 3 by 2 lambda upon a, that come 1 by 2. So that is 3 by 4. So sine theta is equal to how much? 3 by 4. We can say theta is equal to sine inverse 3 by 4. This will be the angular position of first secondary maxima. So first secondary maxima, option D is correct. For this question, remember always, for first minima or nth minima, formula is what? Angular position is n lambda upon a. When we will talk about the secondary maxima, so 2n plus 1 upon n, 2n plus 1 upon 2 lambda upon a. Take care. There first n is equal to 1, if you are putting the 3 lambda upon 2a, this will be the position. So here we can find the angular position of first secondary maxima. One numerical based question is there. An automobile moves on a road with a speed 54 km per hour, radius of wheel 0.4 meter. This is numerical based question. Moment of inertia given 3 kg meter square. If vehicle is brought to rest in 15 seconds. The magnitude of average torque. What will be the magnitude of average torque? First, they see what will be the speed. Speed they have given 54 km per hour converted into meter per second. So 54 into 5 by 18. 18 threes are, so that is 15 meter per second. So this 15 meters per second is velocity. Radius they have given. So what will be the angular velocity? V upon radius r. So this is 15 upon 0.45. we can see here 0, so that will be the 100 upon 3 radian per second. So this will be the initial angular position, correct? Is brought into rest, final is 0 in 15 second, time is 15. What will be the angular retardation? What will be the retardation? If retardation is alpha, to omega t is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. If retardation is there, then you have to take here negative. So 0 is equal to 100 upon 3 minus alpha into 15. Here we can find alpha is equal to what? 100 upon 3 into 15, that is 20 upon 9 radian per second square. So this will be the retardation. So what will be the torque? So torque is equal to what? I alpha, I they have given 3 kg meter square, alpha is 20 upon 9, so 3 threes are 9, so that is 20 upon 3 or 6.666 केजी मीटर स्क्वायर, मीटर स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. तो दिस विल बी द एवरेज टॉर्क, मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एवरेज टॉर्क ट्रांसमिटेड बाय इट्स ब्रेक ऑन व्हील. दिस न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. आंसर यू कैन राइट 6.67 और 6.666. फॉर दिस न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड क्वेश्चन आंसर इज 6.666.